so that they love Mother's Day. When I was a girl growing up, it was so easy to find a card for my mom. She was just such a precious woman, and she loved God with all of her heart. And finding one that said exactly what I wanted, that was pretty easy if the card selection was good, because there were just so many things I absolutely loved about her. And she's been gone 14 years now. This is her 14th year celebrating Mother's Day in heaven. And I was thinking about that last night. I was listening to some songs about mothers and just crying because I missed her so much. And, but I'm so thankful for the legacy that she has left me. Growing up, she just poured her heart into making sure that I would be somebody that God could use. That my heart would be a place that he was pleased to call his home. And she was very diligent in making sure that I knew how to make the bed. I heard yesterday on the radio that some colleges actually have classes where they teach the students how to make a bed. And I thought, oh my goodness, moms are dropping the ball big time. And some of those just simple things that, that you should know growing up. But she taught me how to sew, how to do upholstery. And Craig and I have been able to take that over, and that's been just a wonderful lesson to our family. But if she hadn't been diligent in teaching those things, if nobody else did, I wouldn't know them. And I have so much to be grateful for that my mom imparted her wisdom to me. Thinking back about her character and her love for God, that's what I think of the first thing when I remember my mom. From the time she was just a young woman, God used her to give words of knowledge to people. And I saw so many ways the devil tried to hinder her. And she wouldn't let him. She loved God so much that Satan wasn't going to stand in her way from pleasing God. And I'm grateful for just the different things that I can remember where my mom was steadfast. And there was nothing going to get in the way of her serving God and fulfilling his purpose for her life. And at first, you know, I was thinking about a song that my mom really liked. And Great Is Thy Faithfulness comes to my mind, first of all, because there were so many times when she'd be going through a hard time and she wouldn't be complaining. She'd be singing that song. She would be thanking God that he was faithful and that no matter what, her problem was small compared to his might and his power. And that stands out in my mind so clearly. She could have complained. My sister and I did, you know, we found reasons to be ungrateful. And she would always say, no, you can always find something to be thankful for. Let's focus on how faithful God is. And so I was going to share that song this morning. But then I got to thinking about my role as a mom. My mom, her main role was to teach me to love God. And she did. She taught me to love him more than anything. And that's what I'm endeavoring to teach my children. And so I started thinking about songs that were precious to them, that I've been able to share with them. And of course, the two that they all know really well is Jesus Loves Me and God Is So Good. And I thought as we were getting ready to come up here, if there's two important things that I want them to know, it's those two, that Jesus loves them, that they are so precious in his sight, and that God is so good, that there is absolutely nothing in this world that can take away how good God is. And there's so many other things that they'll be learning through life, but those are standbys. And I am grateful for my kiddos this morning. And so we're going to share those two songs with you. And I'm sure all of you know this. You're welcome to join in.